Dead. I'm just kidding. I didn't die. That's kind of horrible. But all jokes aside, it's good to be back. And today we'll be taking a look at the new Xbox One Elite and see if this upgrade is even worth spending your hard-earned money on. Now, externally, this newly released Xbox One looks exactly the same as the original Xbox One that was released back in 2013. Well, unless if you count the non-glossy finish on the top of the console, which is now a matte type finish. Yeah, there's really nothing new externally. Ports and all remain the same on the back. You got your power, you got your HDMI out, optic audio, HDMI in, two USB 3.0 ports, along with the Kinect port, the IR out, the Ethernet ports, and the Kensington block across the back, along with an additional USB 3.0 port on the side. But what all has changed on this is gonna be made internally, where we will now have a 1 terabyte hybrid drive, which Microsoft claims it'll boot up 20% quicker from standby. This is actually true compared to the day one Xbox One that I had. It's not gonna be a crazy difference, but it is nice to have, and you will notice it when you boot it up. The new hybrid drive also helps install and load games quicker, and the overall experience going from menu to menu or resuming games are an improvement as well. Now, the main attraction with this new Xbox One Elite is the Elite controller it comes bundled with. First off, this controller isn't aimed for your average Joe players. It is designed more for those competitive players or those who game on a regular basis. This Elite controller definitely feels premium. It has some weight to it with a matte finish and grips on the side that overall feels great when gaming. Now, in my opinion, I think this controller looks pretty boss, but aside from the looks of it, this controller is fully customizable, going from the D-pad to the thumbsticks to the triggers and even the new paddles that sit on the back of the controller. With the Elite controller, you also get a hard shell case to pack your controller and different controller parts. It comes with two sets of different sized thumbsticks and your alternative D-pad. Now, when it comes to customizing it, it is very simple. The D-pad and the thumbsticks simply attach magnetically. And for those of you who are probably concerned with the magnets not being strong enough, they are definitely sufficient and hold its place when gaming. So depending what games you're playing, you'll be able to customize the thumbsticks. Now, personally, I like having the taller thumbstick on the right hand side for aiming when it comes to shooter games. And on the left thumbstick, I like having the shorter one so I can control the movement when it comes to shooter games as well. But checking out the triggers, you can also even customize those. You're gonna have some hair trigger locks that will allow you to customize your triggers. So by switching these, it'll help you to become a better shooter, allowing you to fire faster, because what it does, it allows you to press the triggers halfway instead of fully pressing them down. So that way you'll be able to shoot quicker and things of that sort. Now, we also have some paddles here. We have four different paddles, two on each side, and this allows you to do a little more when you are gaming. You can set them to maybe throw a grenade, sprint, or something of that sort. So this could be like a secondary A, B, X, Y button, or maybe assigning one of these paddles to be your sprint button instead of having to click in the thumbsticks when you play games like shooter games. Now, these are magnetically attached, so you can simply remove these. Personally, I only use two when gaming, so sometimes I would just have two paddles attached to the controller. Now, the customizing doesn't stop there, because there is actually an application on your Xbox that allows you to fully customize it to different things, different layouts, and also sensitivity, and it is a crazy way to really customize your gaming experience. Now, additionally, this Xbox One Elite controller, like the newer Xbox One controllers, you now have a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack at the bottom, so you can connect any type of headphones. So that way at night, you don't have to have the TV on full blast. You can simply plug in some headphones and get the experience in your ears. Now you also have the pair button on the top, which not only pairs your controller, but if you double press it, it'll actually disable and enable the paddles on the back. So that way when you are gaming, you don't actually have to go out of the way, go into the settings and all that and turn off the paddles. You can simply double press that button and it'll disable the paddles on the back of your controller. Now I would have to say one of the downsides on this Xbox One Elite controller is the fact that it still takes AA batteries, and you do get those batteries included, along with a micro USB cable that is braided, which is pretty cool, but there's not a rechargeable battery that comes with this so you can utilize that micro USB cable. It doesn't really make sense. Nonetheless, you can buy a rechargeable battery pack and then go ahead and use it in this Xbox Elite controller. Now this Xbox One Elite controller, from my experience, is a badass controller. It comes with a big price tag of $150 though. Now when it comes to pricing on the Xbox One Elite console with the Elite controller, it'll set you back at $500. But when considering the price tag of the Xbox One Elite controller is $150 itself, and if you're already looking to buy the Xbox One Elite controller, I would say it would be a good upgrade for you. That's if you had the 500 gigabyte hard drive, because now you get double the space, and considering that games nowadays take about 50 gigabytes of storage space, I think double the storage space would be a good upgrade. But for those of you who are looking to invest into the Xbox One Elite controller, or you have an older Xbox One with the 500 gigabyte hard drive, I'd say the Xbox One Elite console is definitely worth checking out. But if the Xbox One Elite console isn't something you really care about, but you do want to check out the Elite controller, I'd say definitely pick one up if you can find one. Because at the moment of shooting this video, these Xbox One Elite controllers are on high demand, and there's a reason for that, because these are pretty badass controllers. But if you can get your hands on one, I'd say definitely check it out. I'll definitely be sure to leave a link down below for the latest availability. I've been having an awesome experience with this new controller, so it's definitely worth the money. But other than that, that's gonna wrap it up for this video. In the comment section below, let me know, did you pick up an Xbox One Elite console, or did you pick up just an Xbox One Elite controller? I'm definitely interested in knowing your thoughts and what you think about either the console or the Elite controller. But as always, if you did enjoy this video, let me know by hitting that like button down below. Also, if you want to see more game related content, be sure to hit that like button as well. And if you're not yet, follow me on social media like Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, Facebook, all that good stuff. All of the links are down below in the description. That way you'll be up to date with what is going on and you can interact with me. I'm always active on Twitter, Snapchat, and Instagram, so be sure to follow me on those. And lastly, if you feel like being awesome, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. That way you'll be notified every time I come out with all of my latest videos, because there are definitely a lot of videos in the works to make up for lost time. Anyways, guys, thanks a lot for watching. Appreciate the support very much. And it's good to be back. But other than that, I'll catch you all on the next one. All right? Peace.